Hello children, welcome to today's section. Children, today let's continue our same lesson HTML. Okay, that is Hypertext Markup Language. Last day we were discussed how to open and save HTML and also some tags, that is HTML, head, title, body, and how to apply color to our body and also how to change text of a body. Okay. So that is color. Okay, text of a which one? Color of a text. Okay. So here today let's discuss the alignment and also heading. Okay. So the first one is background. Okay, first one is background. Last section we were discussed how to change background color. Okay. So suppose you want to set your background as an image. Okay, if you want to set an image as your background, then you can use this index body. Okay, under this body section, body, then the keyword is background. Okay, body background is equal to picture path. Okay, so you can take any one picture, right click the mouse, then from the properties you can choose the picture path that you just copy and paste here. But remember one thing, you have to paste that picture path in between double quotes. Next one is heading tags. Okay, last section we were discussed how to apply heading. So, then how to set different sizes for our heading. So here we have six type of heading, H1 to H6. This H1 is the largest size and H6 is the smallest size. Okay. H1 is the largest size and H6 is the smallest size. Okay, based on your heading, you can choose any one heading from here. That is H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. Okay, so first background color, background image, then heading text. The next one is how to align attribute. Okay, see children, to align attribute. That is, you can set your text from either in left side, right side or center. Okay, then to align your attribute, you can use the tag align. That is, align is equal to center. Example, align is equal to center. See the example H6, align is equal to center means here I am giving the text to smallest font. So the smallest font will be displayed at the center of the line. Okay, when you give it as a right, then it will be in the right alignment. When you give it as left, then it will be in left alignment. So these are the different align attributes. So let us check how to apply all these tags in a HTML document. That is, first open one notepad, then do your program. Okay children, so let's start. So this is our HTML document. So you can open any one notepad. See, this one is a notepad. Then you can type your program. So here, starting from HTML, head, title, then heading and alignment. Okay, this program to show the heading and alignment, and also background color and background image will also show you. Then you can close title, then close head, then start body. Okay, see here, body text is equal to blue. Okay, here I am giving body text is equal to blue. Then H1 to H6 headings I given. Okay, that is, this is largest heading. Okay, then this is second largest heading. Then third largest, fourth largest, fifth largest and sixth largest. Here I am giving two body sections. So one we can delete. Okay, one body section we can delete. After that, you can close body. Okay, so you can close by using this backslash, then body, then after that you can close HTML. Okay children, so now our program is over. Then you can save your program. To save your program, click on this file, click on save button. Okay, here you can save your program. First you have to give one file name. Here I am giving the file name as align.html. see, the extension should be .html or htm. Okay, now I click on the save button. Okay children, see, when I minimize this, see, you can see this align. See, now this align, the notepad document is saved as a web page. That's why this chrome symbol is came here. Okay, Chrome is a web browser. Okay, so when you click on this align, now I double click on the, see, now I double click. Now you can see the program, see the web page. Now you can see the web page. See, this is the largest heading, this is the second largest heading, third largest, okay, fourth, fifth, sixth. See the name, heading and alignment. Okay, this heading we are given in the heading section, that's why, sorry, in the title section, that's why here the title is heading and alignment. Okay, so let's take our program again. See, this is our program. So here we can set our background image. To set background image, you can type background is equal to, okay, here you can set your image path in double quotes. Okay, so to choose your image, see in the document section, here in the desktop, okay, on the library section, you can take the pictures. In the sample pictures, from here I am choosing one picture. See, now I am choosing this picture. Okay, so just right click on the, okay, then click on the properties. See, in the properties section, see location. From here you can copy the location. Okay, right click and click on this copy. Then in the program section, background is equal to that location, you can paste here by using Ctrl V. Okay, Ctrl C for copy, then Ctrl V. Then write the image name. What is our image name? I will show you the document again. Our image name is, which one? Image1.jpg. Okay, so that you can write the, here I am typing, image1.jpg. So now our background image is settled. Okay, so let us save the program again. Okay, after that we can run our document. See, this is our web page. Okay, here you just refresh your page. Now you can see that image is set as your background. Okay, so this is how we set our background image in a web page. Okay, children. So let's take our program again. So this is our program. See here, text is equal to blue. That also I gave under. That's why you can see the text in your web page. Then see, these are the different headings: H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, and H6. Okay. Then to align your text, suppose to align the sixth largest, here you can type this align. Align is equal to center. Here I am giving align is equal to center. Again, save your program. Then take your web page. So this is your web page. See, now the sixth largest is left aligned. Now I refresh this one. Now you can see the sixth largest is center aligned. Okay, children. So this is how we set our background image, and also we align our text. Okay, children. Then apply different types of headings to our document. Okay, we can apply color. Okay, that also you can do. So once again, I will show you the code. First HTML, head, title, then close title. This title you can decide. Okay, based on your choice, you can give your title. Then close title, head. Then to set background, use the keyword background is equal to. Here you can write the picture path. To get the picture path, you can choose any one picture from your system. Right click your mouse, then click on properties. From the properties, from the location, you can copy the location, then paste here, then slash that image name. Okay, then so these are different types of heading. Then to align your text, you can use align is equal to left, right, and center. Here I am showing only center alignment. Okay, then close the body, then close HTML. Okay, then you will get a web page like this. Okay, children. So now I believe you understood how to set a background image and also how to change color of a text. Okay, so please don't forget to do the same program in your own system. Please work out with HTML program. It's a very interesting topic. Okay, when you study properly, you can create your own web pages. Okay, children, see you again with another topic. Till then, bye. Thank you.